Hello and welcome to Ola TV. In this video, I am going to show you how to import your pictures, keyword them, and create collections in Lightroom.
So, when you first start up Lightroom, you'd need to import some images to it. To do so, let's click on the Import button or use the key combination Ctrl, Shift, and I on Windows, or Command, Shift, and I on Mac. You could also go to File and select Import Photos and Videos. After you click that, you will get a pop-up window with three different columns. The first column here shows you where you are importing from. So, if you inserted your SD card to your computer, you will import them from your SD card. When you select your folder, you will see all the images that it contains. Here, you can choose which ones you would like to import and which ones you would like to skip. After you do that, you can go to the third column and choose where would you like to import your pictures to. You can also choose to rename your images if you'd like. Inside Lightroom, you will find a very useful feature, which is keywording. Sometimes, when you have too many pictures, it's hard to go back and find the one that you are looking for, especially if it was taken long ago. And this is when keywording comes in handy. We can select all or just one image and describe it with a few words separated with commas. I usually start with the location, then I describe the subject, lens used, mood, and the season. Of course, it will vary from time to time, depending on the situation. Let me show you how I do it. So, all images in my folder were taken in Canada. So, this will be my first keyword that I'm gonna use. I will write winter as well, because that was the season, and park, because all of them were taken in the park. I can be even more specific and say Hyde Park, because that was the specific location of the photoshoot. Now, when I click on import, my images will be imported with the keywords that I chose. Now that we have all of them here, I can go and keyword my pictures separately. So I will choose all the pictures of this model here and I go to the keywording tab. Here I can write the name of my model. Let's say Mary. Whenever I need to find pictures of Mary, I can go to the text tab here, write Mary, and Lightroom will show me all the images that I keyworded Mary. Pretty cool, right? Now, let's talk about ratings. It is very useful to star rate your pictures. Usually, not all of them are the way we wanted them to be, so this is the way to organize them a bit more. Most of the time, I would just go through all of my images and see whether I like them or not. You can also do it in the camera to speed up the workflow. Now, it's easy to display only the pictures with 5 stars, 4 stars, 3 stars, or above 3 stars, eliminating all the other ones that we wouldn't use anyways. Personally, I don't delete my images unless they are completely useless, like completely black or white. Another important feature that I would like to discuss is collections. Collections are key tools for organizing your pictures in Lightroom. To add a collection, let's click on this button here. Now we see all these options here. Collection set is like a big folder for all your collections. For example, I can create a collection set called portraits and inside put other collections like family, children, baby, and so on. There are also smart collections. This is something that I absolutely love using in Lightroom. Let's see how it's done. Click on this button and then create a smart collection. In the pop-up window, we need to change the collection name. If we don't, Lightroom will name it just a smart collection. And when you add more of them, you'll end up with collections called Smart Collection 1, Smart Collection 2, Smart Collection 3, and so on. Use a name that describes what this collection will contain. For example, 3 stars and above, or by the subject name, like Mary. You may choose to add this collection to a collection set. Now that's done, we can add the rules. This part defines what will be inside the collection. In the match section, we have 3 options: all, any, and none. When you choose all, every rule must match for a photo to be included in the collection. If you choose any, the photo will be included as long as it matches at least one of the rules. If you choose none, the photo will be included as long as it does not match a rule. The next section is for choosing what the rule will be. Clicking on this arrow will open the whole list of rules. Let's choose other metadata and keywords. Now we can write Mary in this field here, and Lightroom will create a smart collection only with pictures labeled as Mary. Play with this option to get used to it. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.